Hey there. So for those that don't know me, I'm Will. And this is the story of how I found my soulmate. All because of Chuck. Chuck Bartowski, aka Charles Carmichael. I'll start from the beginning. I had just finished Dexter, and I was lost without a new show to watch. So my friend Justin recommended giving Chuck a shot. Based on probably the reason most people started watching Chuck to begin with. Because Yvonne, who played Hannah in Dexter, was one of the main characters in it. So I gave it a shot, and I got addicted somewhat quickly to the show. And after enduring the emotional roller coaster of Sarah ripping out our hearts over the length of 5 seasons, over and over and over, I was a pretty big fan. In the following months, I wouldn't shut up about the show. And after I got back to the States, I found it kind of hard to find anyone to talk to about the show. That was until December, at least, right before Christmas. I was third wheeling on a date with my friend Chaz. So, quick backstory on that. I was one of the only ones at the time in the unit that had a car, and being the awesome friend that I am, I drove him all the way to DC for a date. So, I'll be back a little bit later. Continue. I sat across the table from the two of them talking about who knows what. The music in the bar was so loud I couldn't hear a thing. So, I scrolled through Tinder. So, I know Tinder isn't what you quite expected. Maybe something like, while shopping for clothes, I locked eyes with a tall, beautiful blonde with amazing eyes and a great smile. And she happened to grab the only Jester shirt in the whole store. But no, it was Tinder. So enjoy the rest of the story. As I scrolled through the wasteland of Tinder, I came across the perfect woman. Tall, blonde, amazing eyes, and a great smile. And her description said simply, Chuck is the best show ever. So I swiped right and hoped for the best. It was a match. So I messaged her, and we talked for the rest of the night. I wanted to take her on a date as soon as possible, but I was visiting Chaz's family in Georgia for the holidays. So even though we couldn't meet yet, we talked the entire time I was gone. After returning to Virginia, we went on a date. We had dinner, and we went to a spontaneous trip in DC to see the Lincoln Memorial. She had lived near DC her whole life and never seen the Lincoln Memorial, even though she shares a birthday with the man. A little bit weird. Anyways, we walked around the parks and talked well into the night about anything and everything, but most importantly about Chuck. Come to find out, I didn't just find a Chuck fan, I found the biggest Chuck fan. I don't just say that because she's seen the whole series 6 full times, but because she owns Chuck shirts, Chuck lunchboxes, Chuck pillows, and a Chuck script. All right, so last time, possibly maybe. So the most important piece of her collection has to be Captain Awesome's head. Well, the statue Captain Awesome's head. It was featured in episode 4 of season 4. Yeah, you don't want to know how much she spent on it. But all the money did go to Operation Smile, so there's that. Back to whatever this guy was saying. After that night, I asked her on another date, and then another date. And then the next thing you know, it's 1.5 years later, and we're still together. Even though my crazy job takes me all over the world, and we're often tens of thousands of miles apart, she's never once second-guessed our relationship, not even for a second. So this past May, I got to do what I wanted to do for so long. I gotta ask the woman of my dreams to marry me, and she said absolutely. So as we plan our wedding coming up this next July, I think about how I never thought a TV show could change my life so dramatically and in such a great way. So I wanna thank you, the cast of Chuck and the crew of Chuck, and send an open invitation to join Paige and I on our wedding. Because if it wasn't for you and the passion that surrounds the show, I would have never found my soulmate. So from the deepest parts of my heart, thank you. And Paige, I love you more than anything in the world.
A year from now, we'll all be gone. All our friends will move away. And they're going to better places. But our friends will be gone away. nothing is as it has been, and I miss your face like hell. And I guess it's just as well, but I miss your face like hell. Talking about the way things change.